Hello guys, today's video will be about how to install and how to use the Substance Painter library with Modo, so let's get started. Once you download the zip file and extract it, you'll find a folder like this one. To install the plugin, you need to open the Substance Painter folder and copy the HH Connect folder to the Allegorithmic plugin path that is usually located in Documents, Allegorithmic, Substance Painter, Plugins. Now, when you open Substance Painter, the plugin will be available, as you can see here. Inside the folder you downloaded, you will find a folder called Modo. Open it and copy the folder called HHSP Live Link. You need to paste it in your Modo Kits folder. You can access it via Modo by clicking the Systems menu, then Open User Folder. If there is no folder called Kits yet, you can create it. Open the Kits folder and paste the HHSP live link. Restart Modo and you'll find the plugin buttons added to your toolbar. To use the plugin in Modo, you have two buttons, a green one to start listening to Substance Painter and a red one to stop listening. Click the green one, set the connection port and click OK. This will allow Substance Painter to communicate with Modo. Now, to use the plugin in Painter, first we need to configure it. To do it, we click the plugin icon in Substance Painter and a window will appear. At the top, we have a pin button. If clicked, the window will always be on top of the UI. Then, we have the output path. Here we choose the export path for the maps that will be generated by Substance Painter. In software, we choose Modo. And a new option will appear called UDIMs. If enabled, the texture sets from Painter will be treated as UDIM textures, and the materials created in Modo will be also configured to work with UDIMs. Then we have the port parameter. This port number must match the one you defined in Modo. Then we have the renderer. At the moment, the plugin supports three different material types: Modo Standard, Unity, and Unreal. It's worth noting that the opacity map is still not available with the Unity material. Then we can define the export resolution, the file format, and the normal format. Modo uses OpenGL by default. If by any specific reason you need a DirectX normal map, the plugin will automatically flip the white channel in the shader to get the correct results when rendering in Modo. Then we can choose to either use one texture file per material map, or optimize the textures and pack more than one material map in a single file. For example, use the same file for the occlusion, metalness, and roughness. Finally, we can select a bit depth of the normal and height map, and a general bit depth for the rest of the maps. To send the textures to Modo, we have two options: either send all the texture sets, or send only the currently active texture set. In this case, I click Send All, and a new material is created in Modo. With the idea of keeping the plugin flexible, since there are a lot of possible workflows, the plugin requires for you to assign the material the first time. So we assign the material, and there you go, it's working. If you don't see the materials after you assign it, check that the right UVs are selected in the Set Texture UV property in the Texture Layer tab of each image map. Now, if we change anything in Substance Painter and send the textures again, we'll be able to see the updated material in the renderer. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via our Discord server.
Good luck!